Hello everyone! Let's explore the Alletra 5000 and 6000 storage CASL architecture in brief. It stands for Cache Accelerated Sequential Layout, which allows us to abstract the cache performance in a very clever and efficient way that the other storage arrays just can't do. Alletra 5K is not a simple hybrid storage with data tiering capability. Using CASL, Alletra 5000 intelligent storage can provide an all-flash feel in an enterprise-class storage. That's the reason why we proudly call it adaptive flash storage instead of hybrid storage. Similarly, we can expect to have an all-SCM kind of feel for an Alletra 6050 or 70 or 90 all-NVMe storage, which we are going to discuss in more detail later on. These are the controllers and the cache storage, and finally, the capacity storage. The cache can be anything faster than what we are going to install in this capacity storage. In Alletra 5000, the cache consists of SSDs, and in Alletra 6050, 70, and 90, these are the storage class memories or SCM sitting over the NVMe SSDs as the capacity storage. When the host or server with any kind of workload like a database or a VMware data store, etc., comes to the controller, the data will be first written on the NVRAM, which is a non-volatile memory. For most other storage systems these days, the data would go all the way down to the capacity tier, and then the acknowledgment would travel all the way back up to the host, creating a lot of latency in such a traditional array. What we can do is, after writing the data to the NVRAM, we perform a shadow copy via PCIe Direct Memory Access or DMA straight to the active hot standby controller. So now, in the event of a power failure, the data is still safe in both of the controllers. So the acknowledgement is sent to the host and then it sends the next data to the controller. This is how we are getting the writing performance of the NVRAM and not the disks of the storage. This NVDIMMs is the most lowest latency flash available on the market today. And it's also the most expensive, so we need to be very intelligent in utilizing these things. These are the actual DDR memories backed by flash and supercapacitor. This acts as normal RAM till the power loss happens. In that case, its contents are moved to the NAND flash and they are eventually restored on power return. After that, the data starts to flush out to DRAM, and from here, the magic of CASL kicks in. We start to do all the data reduction technologies that we have developed over years, such as compression, deduplication, even encryption on per volume basis. And then we build RAID stripes within the memory. Most importantly, we are not bound by any block size like 4K, 8K, or even up to 32K. We really don't care. The data reduction technologies that we use have no performance overhead because we are doing all of this within the DRAM. So there is no benefit in turning them off. It is recommended to keep it always on as an inline data reduction, and our average data reduction is 3:1 on a mixed kind of workload. We are pretty confident on this figure as we found it based on real world scenario. It's actually the true figure taken out from the data analytics that we feed into our AI technology, what we call as the InfoSight. We can do an inline data reduction with encryption without self-encrypting drives. We can do variable block, app-aware deduplication, and adaptive compression with AES-256 encryption. Finally, we will execute RAID 3P plus sequential stripes. Most importantly, at this point, we're still inside the controller, and we do all of these RAID stripes inside the DRAM. We then flush out all the data stripes as sequential I/O in the capacity layer for data protection. We store the data here in 3P plus, where plus is the most important part. So we are doing triple plus parity RAID, which can withstand up to 3 drives simultaneous failure without any data loss. Also, we are doing much more than that in the plus, And the plus is actually cell level rate, where we can actually put our metadata and the parity within the cell orbit or blocks within the drives to ensure that we have actually got data protection from silent data corruption or block errors. We have the most paranoid rate in the storage industry, and therefore there must be a severe or major hardware failure to impact the service. You will be able to lose 3 drives of the capacity layer, and also we can start losing drives to the cache layer as well without any data loss. We send all the data to the capacity and we determine in our own algorithms the data that is cache worthy, and we will copy those out to the read cache for performance bucket. We have an intelligent caching algorithm, what we call as access-based eviction, which allows us to intelligently cache in data on the fly into the flash cache. This data is not raided at all because it's just a scratch space for performance, and the actual data is already protected in the capacity tier. We have this further efficiency in the cache side compared to the other technologies, where in order to get performance, they have to use tiering in faster SSDs. And no matter how intelligent they are, they will have to protect the cache using RAID. In our case, since it's a purely read cache, we don't need to protect it using RAID and can utilize the full capacity of the cache with our unique capability. If you want more performance, you can just swap out the controller without any disruption to the service. We don't have to shut down the full system or the service that is running here in order to upgrade the controllers. But when it comes to the read portion, we are also extremely efficient. We first try to read from the NVRAM, and if we can't find the data there, then we start reading from the DRAM. If we can't get it available on the DRAM memory, then we search for it in the cache. There are typically a 95% probability that we will get the read data within the cache, and we know this fact from the InfoSight, which is there for more than 10 years of AI maturity. So the proprietary algorithm that we run for our flash caching is proven to generate above 95% of actual cache hit ratio. Means that there will be less than 5% chance that the read request might go to the capacity layer. The CASL can also prefetch cache-worthy data into the cache before the read requests are expected to happen. In Alletra 5000 storages, we utilize the SSD performance. And in Alletra 6050, 70, and 90 storages, we can use the SCMs, which is a new type of low latency flash media. In fact, it's almost as low latency as DRAM. We can use this to provide much better performance than NVMe disk on the capacity tier. But we don't have to replace or rewrite any coding in order to achieve this. Thus, we provide the media agnostic, hardware accelerated, intelligent storage system, and this was the story of CASL Architecture. Thanks for your patience in watching this video.